What?
What?
What the hell is this?
Harumph! 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 I didn't get a harumph out of that guy.
Give the governor harumph.
Harumph!
You watch your ass.
I see you shiver with anticipation.
Let the show begin.
Hey, everybody, this is David Heretic coming at you with another edition of Reactions, Reviews, and Rants. And tonight! Okay, we're coming back to Pearl Jam. Yes, indeed. Pearl Jam fans, feeling you. Come on now. Here we go. Before we go any further, for those of you who are feeling inclined to doing all the clicks and the likes and the bibbity bibbity bop, do me a favor. Before you do all that stuff, please watch the whole video first, okay? Give me a chance to actually earn those clicks and likes. Now, after the video's done, if you still feel like doing all those clicks and likes, then by all means, feel free to click away. This comes as a request from Joel Swenson, and Joel wanted to see me react to this song by Pearl Jam called Take the Long Way. Now, have I heard the song before? No, I have not. To the best of my knowledge, this does not resonate with me in any way, shape, or form. However, there's always a possibility I may have heard the song in passing and I just don't realize it. So as always, if I start listening to the song and I suddenly go, wait a second, hold on, I recognize this song, I'll let you know.
That's the truth.
You know me, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. This was posted by Pearl Jam, surprise, surprise, and the video has 492,152 views. It'll get you there. Other than that, there's really nothing else left to say. Link to the original video will be down below in the video description for your viewing pleasure at your leisure. Let's get started. What do you say? Are you ready? Are you ready? Because here we go. All right, here we go. Pearl Jam, Take the Long Way, official visualizer. Wah, wah, wah.
Damn it!
It does not matter what comes of that word official, man. The word official's there. It doesn't matter what comes afterwards. Plus, it's coming off the band's official page, which means the chances and the odds of the video game blocked are going to be a little bit higher. Now, I'm not saying the video's going to be blocked for sure. I'm not saying that. All I'm saying is, because we got that word official, and it's coming off the band's official page, chances and the odds of the video game block can be a little bit higher, so we're going to do what we can, we're going to hope for the best, and we're going to wait and see what happens. All right, let's do this!
All right, boy, let's do this!
You got me through.
Yeah. I'm digging the song. The energy is off the charts. The drive is off the charts. Almost a punk feel to it. Almost, not quite. Just a very nice fast-paced rock tune. 7/4. Not always the easiest time signature to make it sound smooth. You know what I mean? It's not the easiest time signature to work with from a standpoint of making it sound seamless and making it sound smooth. But I gotta give Pearl Jam credit. They are pulling it off. It does sound very natural, very smooth, very easy to groove to with not a whole lot of brain power required, even though it is in 7-4, you know? And it's been in 7-4 the whole time. Trust me, I've been counting. It's been in 7-4 the entire time. It's cool, man. It's a really, really good job. Let's keep going. Now's the time to switch up to 6. Gotta be honest with you folks, I almost missed it. I almost missed it. That's how smooth it was. Dear Lord, good on them. Nice little tune. Give me a couple minutes. Let me get my thoughts together. I'll see you in the review and we'll talk about it. Well, there you go, folks. That was Pearl Jam with Take the Long Way. This was a request from Joel Swenson. Nice little tune, man. No doubt about it. That was a lot of fun to listen to. A lot of fun to count, too. Okay, let's get to it. On a scale of 1 to 10, I'm going to give that an 8.4. Yep, 8.4. I feel good about that score. Let me tell you why.
Why?
Okay. Don't get me wrong. The counting was great, okay? Playing the majority of the song in just straight 7-4 time at that tempo, that was really well done. I gotta say, it didn't feel awkward. It never felt stiff. It didn't feel weird. It was very very easy to groove to. And I think part of that was the tempo that we were at. You know, that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think that definitely helped quite a bit keep it smooth. I've always found that when you play in odd time signatures and you're playing them at a slower tempo, it makes it harder for it to flow. You know what I mean? It feels a little more awkward. So playing at that upbeat tempo, I think that definitely helps quite a bit. Switching into 6-4 after the guitar solo. Wow, I did not see that coming. I gotta be honest with you, folks. I almost missed it. I almost did. I was sitting there grooving along to it, and I started to notice about halfway through to the end, about 30 seconds to the end to go. Actually, a little before that. Probably about 45 seconds to go until the end hit. I all of a sudden I started going, wait a minute, my one's not lining up. I'm not hitting my downbeat on one. It's early every single time. The downbeat's hitting before my downbeat is. So I started counting in six, and oh, well, what do you know? Surprise, surprise, there it is. So yeah, switching to 6-4, nice switch. Didn't see it coming, and I almost missed it. That's how smooth it was. Now, don't get me wrong, those factors were really well done, okay? It was, but, and everybody playing the instruments that they were playing sounded really good. Mike sounded really good. Stone sounded really good. Everybody sounded really good for the most part. Why did I say for the most part? Everybody sounded really good overall. That's what I meant to say. I didn't hear anybody that stuck out. Nothing sounded bad. Everything sounded really good. I dug everything I heard instrumentally. Vocally, very pleasing to the ear, very fitting for the song. So Eddie did a great job as well. What really did the song for me more than anything, though, was the energy of the song, the drive of the song, the feel of the song. Man, borderline punk, almost. I mean, it was up-tempo for sure. And it had that straight-ahead feel. But I don't feel it was fast enough to be punk. I don't feel like it was stiff enough to be punk. Now, this was a very easy flowing, very enjoyable feel. Just a fast-paced rock tune. And I absolutely enjoyed it. I really did. This was a fun tune. Would I ever say this is my favorite song from Pearl Jam? No. No, I won't go that far. But I will say it was definitely enjoyable, and I would have absolutely no problem listening to this song again. As a matter of fact, I don't know if I will or not, but I am definitely giving some serious thought to putting this on my driving playlists, both of them, driving to Vegas and driving around town. I'm thinking, yeah, for both. It's got great energy for driving. I just gotta be careful I don't speed. I don't think I would speed with this song. I don't think there's that much of a drive, but I mean, there's quite a bit, so I might. I have to be careful. No, but I thought it was a great song. I really did, and that's why I'm giving it the great score of 8.4. So, 8.4, final score, I have spoken. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of Reactions, Reviews, and Rants. Hope you all enjoyed the show. Hopefully I was able to entertain you. If I was able to put a smile on your face and brighten your day, I did my job, and I'm so glad I could do it. If you guys feel like joining the fan base, go ahead and click on that button down there. If you guys want to like the video, go ahead and like the video. If you guys want to ring the bell, go ahead and ring the bell. It honestly doesn't make any difference at all to me, but if you guys feel like doing these things, then by all means, feel free to do so. Well, that's going to do it for tonight, folks. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, this is David Heretic signing off, reminding you to stay fabulous and support each other. Later. Peace.